nitro. What they gonna hit that takes so much explosive?
I feel like a Chinese army marched over my back in golf shoes. Where's our relief?
The department won't put up with hot dogs.
You may have forgotten, but there are plenty of others who remember what it's like on the street.
And he's all Tennessee. He was raised to believe we're all equal and free. Like the Crockett's, like the Jacksons, like the stories that you've heard. He's a man, the man of his word. And the road he's chosen to follow brings him to this place and time. Busy streets of Nashville and those hectic city ways. That's the life of a man who's just one of a kind. He's the man behind the badge, Nashville 99.
Saturday night, Sunday morning, ain't it?
Where would you rather be, in church?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I would.
Can't think of anybody that needs it more.
I'm just starving to death. 6.5 hours just sitting here and sitting here.
Well, if this tip is right, I'll buy you breakfast.
I don't want no breakfast. I want Mets barbecue and a beer. And some chocolate pie. You know, I always see them Chicago police keep their war dogs up there in Illinois where they belong.
I tell you what, after we bust these guys, we'll send them a couple of our homegrown yo-yos in exchange, okay?
Yeah. Hey, you know, intelligence, watch these guys yesterday, and they went out and bought detonators, primer cord, nitro. What they gonna hit that takes so much explosive, I wonder?
It's gotta be a safe big enough to make it worth a trip all the way down from Chicago.
This is Unit 2. Time check, please. Over.
6:05, RB.
I feel like a Chinese army marched over my back in golf shoes. Where's our relief?
Cool it. Stand by.
Take a chance on them making us, RB. You pick them up when they cross division, we'll hang back.
Read you now. They're pulling into the old guitar factory, and they're getting out.
All right, move on by and stay out of sight. I'll call you if we need you.
Lock.
Why, to make sure crime don't pay.
Tracy's in trouble.
On the force. No rookies ride with me anymore, never again. I told him to wait in the car. I thought he'd be safe.
Dave, you know better than most. Once you put on that badge, you're never safe.
See, you've gotten tough since you made sergeant.
Just giving him a piece of what the lieutenant gave me, Dave.
Hey, you got a lead on the creep who nailed my partner?
Nothing. Not calling a lot of IOUs. RB.
You got the description. Anybody remote, it looks like him. On wheels, on foot, on a skateboard. Approach with caution, but bring him in.
You figure the guy's still in my zone?
As soon as he sticks his head out of the ground, I'm gonna bag him.
I'd like to be in on the car.
No vendetta, Dave. Now, you're lucky the review board put you back in your car.
Somebody put in a word for me with the board. You?
That's no big deal.
Yeah, I know better, old buddy. They wanted me on suspension, and you fought the good fight to keep me on the street.
Well, we're still not even, Dave. The very fact that I'm a cop at all is because of you.
I didn't get you on the force out of pure motives. I needed a coach for my boxing team.
Yeah? The second day on the job, I piled up my car. You took the blame for it. You pushed me to get my degree at Vanderbilt. You made me go for lieutenant.
On second thought, you're probably right. I made you what you are today.
Dave, about the review board. You're back to work on condition.
What condition?
That I get a full report from you.
I made a statement.
Not good enough. I was there. They want my questions answered.
They want them answered? Who do you?
Don't make it any tougher, old buddy.
When do you want to do it?
This afternoon. Lieutenant Huff.
I'll be at the machine shop with my kids.
Yeah, get that report up to me as soon as you can, huh? Take those to Dave, save you a long trip.
Thanks, Tony.
Not bad, not bad.
Not bad. David's perfect.
See if you can convince him.
Who is he?
He's a foreman of the old colonial foundry. 6 years ago, he was working this same lathe. He's got a job open.
And you're sending me? Why? The only reason I'm here is because you gave me a choice of either being busted or shoring up for this. You never called me nothing but deadhead.
It's the only way I can get you out of here. Deadhead. Danny! I thought I told you to wear these safety glasses.
I can see better without them.
Danny boy, the biggest thing you're here to learn are there rules in this world. And the guys that make it know the rules and live by them.
Listen.
Now, you listen. I'm going to bounce you off that ball and dribble you down the floor until you get the message.
You got it.
Hey.
Stoney.
I'm the new mailman.
Thanks. Just give me a minute to look through this.
Sure.
Finally got enough money for a tool grinder.
Lieutenant Huff, Danny Waters.
Hey, Danny, how are you?
Show him how to finish grind that piece. I'll be right back.
Two. The guy got personal. He killed my partner, so don't worry, I'll take him. How can I miss? I got the best cop in town looking for him.
What you brass did for a living, now I know.
All right, now do you swear that the statements you made are true and so forth and so forth and so forth and sign it?
Teacher gonna give me an A?
Teacher's gonna give you a belt in the mouth.
Hey, Hargrove. Oh, hi, Trace. Yeah.
Yeah, Trace, what do you got?
Lieutenant, can you get down to the alley, Cap?
Is it important?
Well, Raleigh thinks it is.
Okay, I'll be right there.
Breaking the case?
Well, Trace's snitch is usually pretty reliable, but who knows? Take care.
chance to talk to her yet?
No, it's last moment, Lieutenant.
Well, I hope she's got something.
She got everything.
Well, he can make the lane walk. He can make the dumb talk. Open up the eyes of the blind. Well, let's all go down to the river. There's a man walking on the water. Well, come along with me. Well, I want to see this man walking on the water. Oh, yeah. Chill
else. Hey, look. As soon as I make Sergeant, I'm gonna take you out of all this.
Sure, as far as your apartment.
Well, you're safe. By the time he makes Sergeant, he'll be mellower and much, much older. What have you got for us?
Did you ever hear of Willie Gaines?
Used to run policy, handle a little action, got busted, and is doing 1 to 5.
7 months, and he's out on the street.
You know how I feel about parole boards?
He's been hawked to a guy I know for 2 big ones.
That's a lot of loot for a little man.
Yeah, and he promised to pay off a big hunk by tomorrow night.
Interesting.
And he bought a gun?
Forged.
From someplace, he's getting $1,500 for a gun and a ride out of town. If you want to find him, he drives an old South beer truck.
First thing tomorrow morning, I think we'll visit with Willie Gaines.
Lieutenant, you want the bubblegum machine?
Yeah, we'll give him a little siren, too.
Guys were hijackers, man.
He's clean.
Then the gas pedal got stuck, and I was trying to...
Try it again, Willie.
Don't lean on me, man.
Would
no.
you like me to guess what it was you threw out of that truck?
Would you believe a sandwich? How about a wrench?
Willie, you ain't that dumb.
He could be, Trace.
Let me ask you something. Have you got me cold?
Back to the slammer, Willie. How long depends on you?
5 years into $1,500. It's not worth it.
All right, who's your customer? Where, when, how do you contact him?
Jefferson Davis Hotel, 10:30 in my beer truck.
RB, get a beer truck exactly like this as fast as you can.
Okay, Lieutenant.
Now, Willie,
you're going to tell us all about it next time.
Yes, sir.
Car 75 divert southbound traffic at Almond Spring. Car 225 divert northbound traffic at Crestwood and Charlotte.
Cars 55 and 161 close in, and nobody, but nobody, hit a siren and lights. Repeat.
No sirens and no lights. Gun.
How was I to know? I heard a shot.
I wanted him alive, Dave. Didn't you know that?
He killed my partner, Stoney. Didn't you know that?
It's all there in the report, sir.
I want to know what isn't in the report. When you received my radio call, did you hear me say no lights and no sirens?
Yes, sir.
That was an order, not a request. Why did you disobey it?
Well, I was excited, I suppose.
Did Dave Hargrove tell you to disregard my order?
Lieutenant, it was the only way to get through traffic.
Did Dave Hargrove order you to turn on the lights and the siren?
Yes, sir.
You're going to leave.
Do I have to rewrite that report?
No. It's accurate, it's according to the book. It does what you want it to do.
Sir?
It protects your partner. You should have been.
People come to give the teacher a lesson about lights and sirens. And... No. Dave.
Dave, Chet Atkins here. I'm all set for those kids of yours this afternoon. Got the Roy Acuff Museum at Opryland. And the Grand Ole Opry. How's that?
Chet, I can't thank you and Roy enough. I don't know how I'm ever going to pay you back.
Well, just make those kids applaud real loud this afternoon.
Right. I'll see you. I got this bunch of kids, and Chet Atkins arranged for them to see the Roy Acuff Museum and a Saturday matinee.
I've been trying to get Mama a ticket to that performance for a week.
Well, call Chet.
I don't want to bother.
All right, Stoney, you got that look. Let's have it.
I don't know what's happened to you, Dave. You're schizo. I mean, on the one side, you're Santa Claus, the other side, you're Billy the Kid.
But I don't know what's happened to you. Those lieutenant bars made you forget everything I taught you.
Hey, you taught me to protect life, not destroy it. I watched you waste two people in less than a week.
And one 3 years ago, Lieutenant. I got a commendation for that one.
When I decide to come on like your superior officer, Dave, I'll let you know. I'm trying to come on like your friend, and damn it, you're gonna need one.
I used my siren to make sure I was there, to make sure he didn't kill another.
Dave, you're in trouble. The department won't put up with hot dogs, and that's what you've become.
Don't speak for the department, Stoney. You may have forgotten, but there are plenty of others who remember what it's like on the street.
Maybe someday you'll tell me when I became the enemy. Why does he want to see me?
Said he wanted to deal.
Now, what can Willie possibly have to trade off, Sergeant?
I don't know. His lawyer didn't know. DA didn't know, and I sure enough don't know.
This won't take long. Hey, Willie.
Man, you're really something. I'll cooperate, do everything you want. You still buck me.
What do you expect, a traffic ticket? Violation of parole, making false statements to obtain a handgun, possession of a weapon, disposing of evidence.
Okay. But look, I got a little something that might help you.
No promises.
But if it is something, do I get a break?
I do my best.
I gotta have better than that.
That's as good as it gets.
Okay, wait a minute. Okay. You know the guy that got killed? He was set up.
That mean anything to you?
It sure is not worth a word to the DA.
Yeah, but you don't understand. He was on the run.
Willie, who do you think was chasing him?
I know, but he wasn't on the run from you guys. Don't you get it? He was set up and they killed him.
I know he got killed, Willie. I was there.
Guess it doesn't seem like much, huh?
It sure does.
It's funny. It did when he told me.
Hi, Molly.
Hi, Dave. Got a problem?
Two problems. I'm not used to being on suspension, and...
May I have you back on the road in no time?
Yeah, I hope so. Now, you run these off for me?
Sure.
I need my annual reports to prove to the board how good I am.
You know, you have a real friend in Lieutenant Huff.
Why do you say that?
Well, about an hour ago, that young guy who works for him...
Trace Main?
Thinks he looks like Robert Redford. Anyway... He asked me to look up all the homicides in your zone for the last 3 years.
Oh?
Yeah, and there were only two unsolved ones. I think you're up for promotion. Wouldn't that be great?
Call it from Buffalo, Miami, St. Louis. All in one day.
Why?
It's obvious, Chuck. So obvious even you should get it.
Walter, I know these calls are about problems Dave took care of, but tell me why.
Because someone's getting nervous or inquisitive or suspicious.
Dave. No, Walter, I'm finished. No more, never again.
I'm sending the pigeon into your town, your zone. You perform as usual. And you won't hear from me again.
I can't. Now, you don't know Stoney Huff. He's been watching me. And he's not the kind of a guy to back off.
Do it. It's your only route out, Dave.
All right. But remember, the last time.
Underwriter's building. Side entrance. 7 o'clock. You keep your word and I'll keep mine. That'll do it, honey. I've got a job for you.
What?
I want you to go to Nashville and kill a cop.
vending machine, and the sheriff's department gets the wages.
Well, Trace, suppose we take a cut in salary and chip in and...
Don't lose your head, Sergeant.
What do you got, Trace?
I want to talk to you about that, Lieutenant. I mean, sometimes these computer feed-outs, well, they can be, you know, kind of like statistics. You can make them say anything you want them to.
Just tell me what you found out. I know how to read it.
Well, yes, sir, but, you know, you can make anybody look bad. Yes, sir. Zone 22, past 3 years. Robert Ferguson, forced entry, Creighton Brothers Jewelers. And they deal in uncut stones. The officer on duty was Dave Hargrove, but he was wounded before he downed his man, and he got a commendation.
I know.
You know. Okay, sir. Same year, sanitation worker discovered a body in an alley. The man's name was Joseph Frackman, alias Joe Rich, alias John Rudolph out of Seattle.
Did they write it up?
Yes, sir. It was in his zone, still inside.
Go on.
All right. 11 months ago, Dave found a body at the back of the Humboldt building. Now, they do payrolls for about 50 companies.
Got an ID?
Got an ID. Lewis Martin, a.k.a. Lester Markle, a.k.a. Lou Marino out of New Orleans.
What do you got, Harvey?
Well, Lieutenant, I call Buffalo, St. Louis, and Miami. And every one of those dead men was with the mob.
Nashville seems to be their favorite burial ground.
Well, they all had troubles with their own crowd. And Robert Ferguson set up his own organization. Gage was skimming off the numbers taken. Clark out of Miami was rumored to be ready to talk to the feds.
Lieutenant, Dave broke me in. I mean, I rode with him for 16 months.
What do you want me to say?
So what we're taking is dumb.
I think it's stupid. Lieutenant, I think it's impossible.
And we ought to be busted to pound the beat for what we've been thinking.
Ever since that yo-yo went down in the alley of that hotel, I've been saying the same thing. Every night I've been telling myself, not Dave Hargrove. Well, the information is not wrong. And neither am I.
It's almost 2 o'clock.
Go back to bed, Mama.
We don't have to face the world alone, you and me. Whatever it is, let me help. A decision you have to make?
No, it's made. I know what I've got to do. Just have to make myself accept it.
Gotta go right, huh?
Hey, Mikey, get over here.
Mikey.
You get, yeah, I know.
Mikey.
You're gonna wander off. Hey, Mikey, come here. All right, let's stay with it.
We have to talk, Dave.
I gotta take the kids to the museum and later the matinee.
Trace will take them.
You go with him, honey. I'll see you later. Ralph, take them on inside.
Hey, who's in charge here? Me or that skinny cop?
Ralph, you're in charge. I'll buy the popcorn. Go, kids. Move, move.
This isn't gonna be easy for either one of us.
I thought we agreed, let the review board decide.
Now, don't start to con me.
I don't like that, Lieutenant.
You're gonna like what I have to say a lot less.
Got your autograph books?
Yeah.
All right, now, when you get in here, I don't want no hollering and screaming. Now, okay.
Okay.
Just be ladies and gentlemen, okay? Wait a minute, have we lost anybody? Ralph. Oh, he's gonna get the popcorn, okay. Okay, come on, come on.
Yeah, you're wrong, Stoney.
No, I'm not.
It's
It's going to take a long time to get the taste out of my mouth, but I'm right.
There are two sides, remember? Everything's got two sides.
Even a rock. You know what you get when you turn one over.
You don't want to hear me out, do you?
A cop has to live by the rules.
Look, you want it from the beginning?
If that's the only way you can tell it.
Well, he set me up, Stoney. And I never knew it. I met this Detroit cop at a convention. He gave me a tip on this pusher they thought was working our area, and I made the collar.
We get tips, we give tips.
I sent him a box of cigars to say thank you, and he calls me with a tip on a heist. I got a promotion for that collar.
And then the collar started to come in dead.
Then a friend of this cop called me. There's a creep due in town, a yo-yo with a record of assault. Three murders, one arrest, no convictions. He was carrying a .44 Magnum. He drew it, and I wasted him.
Go on.
A week later, a surprise, an envelope came. $2,000 in cash and a thank you note.
Why didn't you send it back?
Lord knows. If anybody needed killing, he did.
Why didn't you send it back?
I needed it.
No cop needs money that bad.
The trade center needed it to keep the kids from turning into the scum that I was wasting.
A hitman for the mob? There's no way you can rationalize that.
All I did was knock down slobs who were better off dead.
Well, who the hell ever appointed you judge and executioner?
Stoney, look at me. I'm your friend.
All right, friend. Now, you listen to me. We swore an oath. It meant that people could turn to us for help. They could trust us. They could yell for a cop and they'd know we wouldn't turn on them.
Don't give me that holier than thou.
You are no better than the scum you killed. You're worse. We know them for what they are. They don't put on a blue uniform and then pretend that they're the law.
The kids I saved, that's my life.
Damn it, I told you not to con me. There is no reason on God's green earth for a cop ever to use his gun for profit.
Always by the book. That's all that matters to you is the book.
When I was a rookie, I had a good teacher.
You have to take me now?
Yeah.
Well, I got some bills to pay, a letter to write, get the kids home.
Trace will get the kids home.
Last favor for him. Could you meet me at the Underwriters Building at 7:30 tonight?
Dave, you know I can't do that.
Trust me, Stoney. I'll be there. I never lied to you.
I just wish you'd never lied to yourself.
This harp was used to entertain a president, Theodore Roosevelt, in the White House. And like all the other rare instruments in this exhibit, they're all a great part of our great American history. I tell you, I got to go do a matinee at the Grand Ole Opry.
Mr. Atkins, could I, that trouble you for an autograph, please?
Aren't you, a little old for autographs?
No, sir. I don't think so. See, I'm a picker.
Are you?
Yes, sir. I've taken all your lessons. I'm up to lesson four.
Really?
Yes, sir.
That's good. Let's see how you're doing. I've got a couple of guitars down here. Play me a little rhythm, you know?
Really?
Yeah. You have any of my albums?
Yes, sir. I got them all.
You remember Baby's Coming Home?
Oh, yes. I love that one.
Play me some rhythm.
Okay, so I know the chords, please.
L. Thank you.
that.
Hey, hello, Stoney.
Good to see you again, Chet.
Thank you.
I'll give you a call.
Okay.
Business, Trace.
Well, I better go.
Just have to see.
Now, Mama, I know the honky rolling gun in town. Every chick's a yellow head smiling.
I mean, we had coffee, get your hair cut. Had coffee, get your dry cleaning. We had coffee, now we're listening to
the fiddling. I know.
Well, why don't we just go pick the man up?
He said 7:30 in front of the underwriter's building.
You mind telling me why?
Because that's the way he wanted it, and that's the least I can do for him.
Hey, fellas, airport detail just called. Guy out of Chicago came in on the 5:30, rented a car. Has a return ticket on the 9 p.m. He's a paid killer.
I thought it'd be you.
Anybody accept this Stoney Huff on to you?
Why?
Well, Walter's a fair guy. He's giving you a chance.
You mean straight on or in the back?
Huh. You are Stoney Huff.
You down him, Chuck. I'd take you and Walter and everybody else.
You made the choice.
Creep. One reason, and it'll take every bullet in this gun to drop you.
Okay. Why'd he come here?
I came here to die. If all of you kids whose lives you touched amount to something, then he will have died for something. Those of you who were his friends can make his life meaningful by being what he wanted you to be, whole and decent and worthy men and women. Dave was a man, special, but human. Like all of us, he'd made mistakes. He sinned. And we cannot judge him with our finite minds. We pray that he will be judged by a God of infinite understanding, compassion, and mercy. Amen.
The eulogy was beautiful.
It isn't often that a man can contradict Shakespeare. Evil that men do lives after them. Good is often interred with their bones. Dave left a letter for me to use his insurance policy to keep the Trade Center going and his pension. Vacation pay, sick leave money, to go to a scholarship fund for the kids of cops who are killed in the line of duty.
That's a lot of good, but not enough to balance the scales.
Well, in the end, he knew that. I really believe he knew it and accepted it and chose to die for it.